Η δραματική ιστορία του Ρίκι Βέρ Τζούνιορ, του νεότερου πληροφοριοδότη στην ιστορία του FBI, περιγράφεται στην ταινία White Boy Rick, η πόλεμος ναρκωτικών, όπως είναι ο ελληνικός τίτλος. Η πλοκή εκτυλίσσεται στους κακόφημους δρόμους του Ντιτρόιτ, των 80s, όπου ο πρωταγωνιστής από καρφί γίνεται βασιλιάς ναρκωτικών. Δηλώσεις του σκηνοθέτη και πρωταγωνιστών εξασφάλισε ο Αλέξανδρος Λιζάρδος.
Ο πόλεμος ναρκωτικών κάνει την πρεμιέρα του στο φεστιβάλ του Τορόντο και λίγες μέρες αργότερα ανοίγει στις αμερικανικές αίθουσες. Υπόθεση της ταινίας, η αληθινή ιστορία ενός 16χρονου που από πληροφοριοδότης του FBI γίνεται έμπορος ναρκωτικών.
Certain stories don't surprise you, but it surprised me that it was being made. So I was very excited. My first impression was like, this is going to be interesting because this is going to be provoking. This is going to provoke both people and the society that we live in.
Ο Γαλλο-Αλγερινός Γιάν Ντεμάντς, που φημολογείται πως θα είναι ο σκηνοθέτης του 26ου James Bond, καθοδηγεί τον Μάθιου Μακόναχη σε μια απίστευτη αληθινή ιστορία.
Even though we're watching the dark side of the American dream, we can understand the optimism that the characters have, the humor that they have, and the way that they try to connect family with whatever that means.
It took a while, like research, because it's a true story. You know, I had to spend time visiting the real Rick in jail and trying to get under the skin of who the father was, because the father's passed away in 2014. And it became very clear to me that he was a man who believed inherently in all his DNA, believed in America and the promise of America. Because his father and the generation that preceded him, they, if they had a job for life, and as long as they did the right thing, as long as they worked hard and kept their head down, their circumstances would get better. And all of a sudden, the landscape changed. And as we know, Detroit, everything collapsed.
Ο πόλεμος ναρκωτικών τοποθετείται στη δεκαετία του 80, όταν ο Ρίκι Βέρ Τζέι κατέληξε να είναι η είδηση της ημέρας.
I think you always want to play characters that are laid, otherwise it's a bit boring. But anyway, it was pretty daunting for me, like when I first read it. You know, it's a time and a place and a country that is I'm not familiar with. So it was challenging in that sense. But when I first met Jan, he said to me something that was just really important about Dawn, which is that she's the kind of only character in the film that is really clear about everything that's going on. She sees it. She's objective. She's outside of the situation of what's going on with her brother and with her dad. And she has complete clarity throughout the movie. And she just loves him so much. She's almost like a mother figure to her brother too. And it's a shame that her addiction kind of stunts that, because that moment when they're in the diner together, you can see that all she wants to do is kind of go with him and look after him, and she can see that he's in trouble, but her addiction is kind of like pulling her away from him.
Ο πόλεμος ναρκωτικών κάνει πρεμιέρα στην Ελλάδα σε δίσκους οικιακής θέασης.
Και εδώ ολοκληρώθηκε το δελτίο μας. Σας ευχαριστούμε που μας παρακολουθήσατε. Ακολουθούν οι αθλητικές ειδήσεις με την Άρια Γάτσα και στη συνέχεια η παράσταση στα Μάτια Κραουνάκης. Όλοι ένα, φίλαμε. Κυρίες και κύριοι, καλό σας βράδυ.